Flawless is the desire for flawless skin. And nature has always been a friend. Introducing Apsara Skincare, made with all natural ingredients for all skin types, bringing ancient wisdom into modern skincare. Visit apsaraskincare.com today. Go natural. It's good karma.
Hi, I'm Sudevi, and I'm here today with Sheetal, the founder of apsaraskincare.com. And Sheetal is going to teach us a lovely recipe based on Ayurveda. And I believe today is that we're learning a mask for acne-prone or oily skin?
That is right. This is a really simple one and a very effective one for an oily T-zone that tends to be acne-prone.
Great. And I went through that myself in my early 20s.
Yeah.
So my heart goes out to all who have this problem.
And it is not an uncommon problem. There are just so many people.
Yes.
But with natural ingredients and persistence and a daily skincare routine, one can see amazing results with the health of one's skin. And that does include acne.
Great. That's really good because, of course, we all want that glowing, healthy looking skin.
I bet you.
Great.
We do.
So what are you showing us today?
So a simple three-ingredient facial mask recipe. Ingredient number one is cumin powder.
Mm.
1 teaspoonful of that.
Great.
And 1 teaspoonful of nutmeg powder. And you can just powder it at home. This is very easy. That's a nutmeg. And
is it better to powder it yourself? I guess it's fresher.
It is fresher. Yeah. So it's not been sitting around for a while and you are getting it right from the source. So just a little bit of grinding will give you 1 teaspoonful of nutmeg powder. And nutmeg powder and cumin powder both have been suggested in Ayurveda really quite highly for their anti-inflammatory properties.
Oh, wonderful.
That is right.
And could that even be put on a bug bite?
I believe it could be.
Maybe?
Yeah, to reduce the redness and also to decongest the skin.
Perfect.
Both of these ingredients are quite wonderful. And then to these two, we are going to add 2 tablespoonfuls of corn flour or besan. And besan in English is gram flour. So either or is fine.
Okay.
And so we have the 3 powdered ingredients in. Now we are going to add enough almond milk to form a paste.
Great.
So almond milk is a wonderful substitute to regular milk.
Wonderful. So for people like me who have gone vegan,
that is right,
eliminating all animal-based ingredients.
Right, right.
It's so nice to see some Ayurvedic recipes with that in mind.
That's exactly right.
Great.
Yes, that's exactly right. So almond milk gives you a lot of nourishment, just as milk would, and just as you said, if you're vegan, then it becomes quite a nice recipe for you. But even if you weren't vegan, using almond milk has some great benefits for your skin. It's very nourishing, and it wets this recipe to the extent where it can be applied on the skin.
Wonderful. So I guess even the non-vegans out there, people can stock up on a little bit of almond milk, and it has this benefit.
That's right.
Perfect.
It's good for all skin, everybody, vegan or non-vegan.
Perfect.
So here we have a thick paste, which is the consistency where it can be applied all over your skin, and that's exactly what you're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
Apply it all over your skin and your neck. Don't go too close to the eye area.
So it's not just the T-zone, it can be used all over.
It can be everywhere, but if you want to just only get your T-zone, that's reasonable, that's okay too.
Yes.
It is.
Great. And what about people who develop acne on their chest or their back? Could this even be used?
That's a good one. Yes,
okay.
It could be. Wherever acne appears.
Wonderful.
Now, the thing about acne is that usually the manifestations on the skin are the same. You know, the reasons could be different, but it manifests itself in a similar manner, be it on the back or some people have it on the chest, just as you said. So this can be used anywhere.
So once this is applied to the face, how long should I leave it on?
You should leave it on till it begins to dry or it's kind of midway dry.
Okay.
But that takes about 10 to 12 minutes typically.
Right.
Do not leave it on after it's dry because whatever it needs to have done, it would have done in the 10 to 12 minutes.
Okay.
You really don't need to stretch out your skin or kind of force any nourishment out of your skin because the mask got too stiff.
Okay.
Right. And then you just wash it off. And then, as I always say, follow with your serum and your lotion. Do not forget that. It's very important to have a daily skincare routine.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Sheetal.
You're welcome.